These three diseases are caused by both Pectobacterium and Dickeya, and there are multiple species within these genera, but some of the more aggressive ones are in the genera of Dickeya. We always see a little bit of this disease throughout the growing season in potato production, but until recently it hasn't been a major problem.
The new strain of blackleg, which is Dickeya, is a big deal. The biggest thing on the Dickeya, I think, is make sure you know what you're planting. You know, you're gonna bring it in. That's how you're gonna get it. It's gonna be brought in.
For the symptomatic samples, before isolation, we will just sterilize them, and then we'll rinse them in the water, and then we'll isolate them into selective media. It's pectomalytic bacteria that produces pectinases. When they do that in the plates, we will see these little pitted areas. These bacteria also can be present in the tubers. They will be asymptomatic, which they won't show the symptoms right away. So you won't be able to see them with your naked eye, but they can be present in the tubers. We receive tubers, we'll core the stem end. The bacteria will release into a buffer. Then we'll collect the bacteria, we'll place them into low oxygen environment. We do molecular analysis to identify what species we have.
The typical symptoms of this disease, early on, the symptoms might look like upper leaf curling or wilting of the plant. Blackleg is typically the symptoms occur at the base of the stem, and you usually get black or necrotic areas. And you can see when you cut open a stem that the xylem or the vasculature of the plant will become dark brown.